Daniel Chertow, and we're at the Clinical Center at the National Institutes of Health. I study influenza. So influenza is one of the common respiratory diseases that causes seasonal epidemics in the United States and has a threat of causing periodic pandemics, which can cause worldwide infections and in some of those cases, pretty severe infections. You know, I grew up in a household of two working parents. I got into medical school, had a wonderful experience at Northwestern Medical School, beginning to finally feel like the stuff that I was studying was going to be the stuff that was the primary focus of my life, to be able to apply my knowledge to be able to help folks. And it was during that time that I was sort of deciding, well, where am I going to be next? You know, what is the course? And it was at that point that I said, okay, you know, I had heard about this program at the Centers for Disease Control called the Epidemic Intelligence Service, where they basically train you to do applied epidemiology, which is they teach you how to do surveillance for disease, and they teach you how to evaluate and investigate and shut down disease outbreaks. And was very fortunate to get a spot in this program. I spent my 2 years in the Florida State Health Department doing the whole spectrum of disease epidemiology, from disaster medicine. We had hurricanes during the time that I was there. And so I began to learn about influenza. I began to learn about early studies in people of influenza. Ended up here and am now trying to affect disease and health by trying to understand how does influenza and other respiratory viral pathogens, how do they induce severe illness? Where is the opportunity to make a difference in the outcome of that critically ill person that I see in the ICU? Where is the opportunity for an intervention to make a difference in the outcome, live, die, long-term morbidity, or otherwise? And that is really what has put me in the place that I am, looking for the place that, yeah, let's try to understand this better, but for the purpose of ultimately affecting human health. That's really what it comes down to. I've spent a lot of time developing models for disease, so it's a fully differentiated, pseudo-stratified epithelial layer with beating cilia and mucus production, just like you would see in the airway. We can do this in a petri dish. And we can begin to use those cells and that model to say, how do respiratory viruses get into cells? Where do they bind? How do they enter? What early triggers of the immune response do they set off? How do those triggers affect downstream aspects of disease pathogenesis, either induced by the virus, the bacterial co-pathogens, or the host itself? The host having an excessive or in some cases insufficient inflammatory response to get the disease under control. So we're working on developing the tools to better understand what it is that is going on in that process. We can't do this ourselves. It's a massive collaborative effort. We grow cells in vitro. We evaluate those cells over time, over the course of a month, using microscopic techniques, you know, using the microscope, looking at the cells, making sure that we have adequate growth, that those cells are not infected, that the cilia are functioning normally, that there's mucin production. So we work in this setting. To be honest with you, one of the things that I like most about my job is that I have a mixed day, that every day can be different. One day I may be growing up virus, you know, I may be titering virus, I may be infecting cells, I may be collecting samples from those cells, I may be going into the high containment environment with the extra personal protective equipment. And then there are the other days that I spend a lot of time by the computer, to be honest with you, because the other part of what we do is not just doing the science, but and a very important part of it is communicating what it is that we have found. So this is an electron micrograph image of multiple influenza particles. These are 100 nanometer size particles, so extremely small. 10 to the ninth, you know, 10 to the minus ninth meters, you know, extremely small particles. And so those are some images of what flu looks like. And this is flu just coming off of the cell. And you can see cut and cross section here, because these are cultures that are infected not just with virus, but with bacteria, which is, very neat to capture at that level. So I spend a lot of time putting together oral presentations of the work that we're doing so other collaborators internally and externally understand what it is that we're doing, presenting at meetings, that type of thing. And then putting this information down in manuscripts for peer review. Our colleagues can say, yeah, this holds water, this doesn't hold water, we can replicate this, we can't. And putting it together so that we can get it published and so that the next group of scientists that are working on this also know what we've achieved and you can use that as a starting point to achieve what their goals.
So we're planning on bringing over another 10 vials of cells.
Okay. No problem.
So on Thursday. On Tuesday, maybe we can plan on putting them into culture.
Okay.
So that the thought would be that we have fully differentiated cells,
right,
maybe in beginning of September.
Okay, sounds good.
Despite our best efforts, we have very few drugs and therapies in our armamentarium. We have antiviral medications that have a minimal impact. So we need a generation of scientists to try to have a way of altering the disease course above and beyond what we have to get down to reduce the burden of illness, the morbidity, the mortality associated with respiratory viral illness. Work hard, be passionate, prepare yourself for opportunities so that when they arise, you can take advantage of them. You know, oftentimes we come up with this concept that I'm going to have this exact direct path that you know from time zero what you're going to do. That certainly wasn't the case with me, and I would argue that that's not the case in general. But what is more realistic is you go through life, you achieve, you obtain skills, you obtain knowledge, and you wait. You prepare yourself for the opportunity to present itself. I came here, I didn't know that I was going to have the opportunity to work in a flu lab and work on high containment pathogens, but I prepared myself. And so that when the opportunity came, I took advantage of it, and things have worked out. So work hard, open your mind to opportunities, be prepared, and take advantage of opportunities when they present themselves.